Devotional Prayers, Prayers to the Blessed Trinity, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Welcome to Jocelyn's Time Vlog. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Make sure to hit the bell notification button to keep you posted. Love you guys. Thank you.
Devotional Prayers, Prayers to the Blessed Trinity. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Prayer to the Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful, and kindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. Let us pray. O God, who did instruct the hearts of the faithful, by the light of the Holy Spirit, grant that by the gift of the same Spirit, we may be always truly wise and ever rejoice in His consolation. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Evening Prayers. Prayer to the Blessed Trinity. I adore you, my God, and I thank you for having created me, for having made me a Christian, and preserved me this day. I love you with all my heart, and I am sorry for having sinned against you. Because you are infinite love and infinite goodness, protect me during my rest, and may your love be always with me. Amen. Devotional Prayers, Prayer to the Blessed Trinity. Our prayer life should manifest the fact that the Blessed Trinity constitutes the central reality for Christians. Our entire lives are lived in the loving embrace of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. God the Father is the Creator, God the Son is the Redeemer, and God the Holy Spirit is the Sanctifier, but not in such a way that the Son and the Holy Spirit are excluded from creation, or the Father and the Holy Spirit from redemption, or the Father and the Son from sanctification. Prayer and Praise of the Trinity. I venerate and glorify you, O most blessed Trinity, in union with that ineffable glory with God, the Father, in His omnipotence, honors the Holy Spirit forever. I magnify and bless you, O most blessed Trinity, in union with that most reverent glory with which God the Son, in His ineffable wisdom, glorifies the Father and the Holy Spirit forever. I adore and extol you, O most blessed Trinity, in union with that most adequate and befitting glory with which the Holy Spirit, in His unchangeable goodness, extols the Father and the Son forever. Prayer to be conformed to the divine will. Most Holy Trinity, Godhead indivisible, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, our first beginning and our last end. You have made us in accord with your own image and likeness. Grant that all the thoughts of our minds, all the words of our tongues, all the affections of our hearts, all the actions of our beings may always be conformed to your holy will. Thus, after we have seen you here below in creation, and in a dark manner by means of faith, we may come at last to contemplate you face to face forever in heaven. Prayer of Consecration to the Trinity. O God, I vow and consecrate to you all that is in me, my memory and my actions to God the Father, my understanding and my words to God the Son, my will and my thoughts to God the Holy Spirit, my heart and my body, my tongue, my senses, and all my sorrows to the sacred humanity of Jesus Christ, who was content to be betrayed into the hands of wicked men and to suffer the torment of the cross, by Saint Francis de Sales. The Trinity. God the Father, He is my Father and Creator. He is more my Father than the one I have had on earth. I owe everything to Him, my being and my life. I love him greatly and with a very filial love. I desire his glory and his reign. The Son of God has become my brother by incarnation. He has given his life for me. He comes to me in the Eucharist. I love him without measure. I lean unceasingly on his shoulder as Saint John did. I desire to live with him and always to love him before all else. The Holy Spirit is my director, my guide, the soul of my soul, as it were a mother to me. I desire to live with him, to listen to him in everything, to show myself as his loving and faithful disciple. The God who calls the Holy Trinity. God first revealed himself as Father and Friend. He called Abraham to walk with him, to Moses in the burning bush. He even revealed his name, Yahweh. It means he who is with us and for us. He who will never let us be alone and helpless. When we did need help, he sent his Son. The outpouring of his love for whom he made his universe. He is the Emmanuel, the proof that the Father lives up to his name. He is God with us. Before returning to his Father, Christ revealed that there is a third person in the one God. After he returned, he sent the Spirit because he did not want to leave us orphans. The Holy Spirit, whose temple we are, does for us what Jesus did for his disciple. While on earth, he teaches, guides, defends, consoles, and comforts. Thus the one God revealed himself as the Trinity of persons. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. To Corinthians, Chapter 13, verse 13. Amen. In praise of the name of God, Yahweh. Father, the pagans tried to second guess their gods by trying to find out their secret names. You, however, revealed your name, Yahweh, to us. It is full of promise. Blessed be your name forever. From the burning bush, down through endless ages, we praise your name, for it gives us such hope knowing that you are a God who is with us and for us. Blessed be your holy name, now and for endless ages. Amen. Praise of the Trinity. Almighty, eternal, just and merciful God, have us poor, riches for your sake. Though what we know, you want and have us always want whatever is pleasing to you. So that cleanse interiorly and interiorly enlightened and aglow with the fire of the Holy Spirit, we may be able to follow the footsteps of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Aided by your soul-saving grace, may we be able to get to you, who in perfect Trinity and simply unity, live and reign and triumph, Lord Almighty, world without end. Amen. Francis of Assisi. Doxology. Glory be to the all-powerful Creator, all-loving Father, and all-wise God. Glory be to the Son, source of saving grace, fountain of love and filled with mercy. Glory be to the Holy Spirit, consoler, comforter, and defender. Glory, praise, honor, and blessing to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Prayer to the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit of God, when we do not know how to pray as we ought, you cry out in our behalf. It is you who have been poured forth into our hearts who make us able to cry, Abba, Father. Jesus left you in our midst that his work might be continued. We are your temples, and in us you are the pledge, guarantee, and promise of eternal life. Send forth your gifts among us, that we may be sign of your new creation in this world so often on the brink of chaos. Amen. Credo. God our Father and Creator, we believe in you and hope in your goodness. God the Son, our brother and Redeemer, we believe in you and we hope in your saving acts. God the Spirit, our inspiration and guide, we believe in you and hope in your wisdom. We believe in the people of God, the church, and hope in this way of salvation. We believe, help our unbelief. Amen. Reverend David Schemel. Prayer for guidance. Come, Holy Spirit, come, Divine Wisdom, come, Counselor left by Jesus so that we would not be orphans. Enlighten my mind to make the proper decision. Strengthen my will so as not to regret it. Help me always to choose what is pleasing to you and therefore best for me and my family. Grant me a listening heart to hear the wisdom of which you are the source. Amen. Prayers to the Holy Spirit. Before ascending to the Father, Jesus told his apostles that he would send them the Holy Spirit, who would be with them forever. On the day of Pentecost, the Spirit of love and truth descended upon the apostles, gathered in the upper room, and filled them with power and light. The Holy Spirit comes to each disciple of Christ and takes possession of every soul that opens to His grace. We must strive to be open and docile to the sanctifying actions of God's Spirit in us. Prayer to receive the Holy Spirit. O King of Glory, send us the promise of the Father, the Spirit of Truth. May the Counselor who proceeds from you enlighten us and infuse all truths in us, as you have promised. For the seven gifts of the Spirit. O Lord Jesus, through you I humbly beg our merciful Father to send the Holy Spirit of grace, that he may bestow upon us his sevenfold gifts. May he send us the gifts of wisdom, which will make us release the tree of life that is none other than yourself, the gift of understanding, which will enlighten us, the gift of counsel, which will guide us in the way of righteousness, and the gift of fortitude, which will give us the strength of vanquish the enemies of our sanctification and salvation. May he impart to us the gift of knowledge, which will enable us to discern your teaching and distinguish good from evil. The gift of piety, which will make us enjoy true peace, and the gift of fear, which will make us shun all iniquity and avoid all danger of offending your majesty. To the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit be given all glory and thanksgiving forever. Saint Bonaventure. For the 12 fruits of the Spirit. Holy Spirit, eternal love of the Father and the Son, kindly bestow on us the fruit of charity, that we may be united to you by divine love, the fruit of joy, that we may be filled with holy consolation, the fruit of peace, that we may enjoy tranquility of soul, and the fruit of patience, that we may endure humbly everything that may be opposed to our own desires. Divine Spirit, be pleased to infuse in us the fruit of benignity, that we may willingly relieve our neighbor's necessities, the fruit of goodness, that we may be benevolent toward all, the fruit of longanimity, that we may not be discouraged by delay, but may persevere in prayer, and the fruit of mildness, that we may subdue every rising of ill temper, stifle every murmur, and repress the susceptibilities of our nature in all our dealings with our neighbor. Creator Spirit, graciously impart to us the fruit of fidelity, that we may rely with assured confidence on the word of God, the fruit of modesty, that we may act becomingly, and the fruits of continence and chastity, that we may keep our bodies in such holiness as befits your temple, so that having by your assistance preserve our hearts pure on earth, we may merit in Jesus Christ, according to the words of the gospel, to see God eternally in the glory of His kingdom. Prayer for union with the Holy Spirit. O Holy Spirit of light and love, to you I consecrate my heart, mind, and will for time and eternity. May I be ever docile to your divine inspiration and to the teachings of the Holy Catholic Church, whose infallible guide you are. May my heart be ever inflamed with the love of God and love of neighbor. May my will be ever in harmony with your divine will. May my life faithfully imitate the life and virtues of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To him with the Father and you, Divine Spirit, be honor and glory forever. Saint Pius X. Arts Confraternity Prayer to the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, Lord of Light, from your clear celestial height, your pure beaming radiance give. Come, O Father of the poor, come with treasures which endure. Come, O Light of all that live, you of all consolers feast, and the soul's delightsome guest. Though refreshing peace bestow, you and towel are conformed sweet, pleasant coolness in the heat, solace in the midst of woe. Light immortal, light divine, visit now this heart of mine, and my inmost being fill. If you take your grace away, nothing pure in man will stay. All their good is turned to ill. Heal our wounds, our strength renew. On our dryness pour your dew. Wash the stains of guilt away. Bend the stubborn heart and will. Melt the frozen warm and the chill. Guide the steps that go astray on all those who evermore you confess and you adore. In your sevenfold gifts descent, give them comfort when they die. Give them life with you on high. Give them joys which never end. Prayer for the indwelling of the Spirit. Holy Spirit, powerful consoler, sacred bond of the Father and the Son, hope of the afflicted, descend into my heart and establish it in it your loving dominion. Enkindle in my tepid soul the fire of your love, so that I may be wholly subject to you. We believe that when you dwell in us, you also prepare a dwelling for the Father and the Son. Deign therefore to come to me, consoler of abandoned souls, and protector of the needy. Help the afflicted, strengthen the weak, and support the wavering. Come and purify me, let no evil desire take possession of me. You love the humble and resist the proud. Come to me, glory of the living and hope of the dying. Lead me by your grace, that I may always be pleasing to you. Prayers to God the Father. By nature, God is our Creator and Lord, and we are His creatures, and subject as a result of sin. However, we have become His enemies and deserve His chastisement. Yet, through the grace of Christ, the Father lovingly pardoned us, adopted us as his children and destines us to share in the life and beatitude of the same Christ, his only begotten Son. Prayer to the Father enable us to balance his supreme perfections and transcendence with his loving concern for the least of his creatures. Prayer of praise and petition. We praise you, invisible Father, giver of immortality and source of life and light. You love all human beings, especially the poor. You seek a reconciliation with all of them, and you drew them to yourself by sending your beloved Son to visit them. Make us really alive by giving us the light to know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. Grant us the Holy Spirit and enable us to speak volumes about your ineffable mysteries. Prayer to the Father for the benefits of Christ's redemption. Eternal Father, I offer you the infinite satisfaction which Jesus rendered to your justice in behalf of sinners on the tree of the cross. I ask that you would make available the merits of his precious blood to all guilty souls, to whom sin has brought death. May they rise again to the life of grace and glorify you forever. Prayer of thanks for the Father's love. Eternal Father, we thank you for your great love. You give the world the best of yourself, the mirror of your perfect transparency, the splendor of your very being, your Son Jesus. We thank you for giving Jesus to us as our Savior, not as a tyrant, but as a friend, not as a superior, but as a brother. Help us to open our hearts to his light without fear of being overwhelmed, but exultant with the joy that comes from his light upon all who accept it with gladness. Prayer to the Father for reconciliation. Heavenly Father, in the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, your Son, you willed to reconcile all mankind to yourself, and so to reconcile all human beings with each other in peace. Hear the prayer of your people. Let your spirit of life and a holiness renew us in the depths of our being and unite us throughout our life to the risen Christ, for he is our brother and savior. With all Christians, we seek to follow the way of the gospel. Keep us faithful to the teachings of the church and alive to the needs of our neighbors. Give us strength to work for reconciliation, unity, and peace. May those who seek the good, the God they do not know yet, discover in you the source of light and hope. May those who work for others find strength in you. May those who already know you seek even further and experience the depths of your love. Forgive us our sins, deepen our hearts, our faith, kindle our hope, and enliven our hearts with love. May we walk in the footsteps of Jesus as your beloved son and daughters. With the help of Mary, our mother, may your church be the sign and sacrament of salvation for all people, that the world may believe in your love and your truth. Prayers to God the Son. Our knowledge of God is communicated to us by God the Son, made man, Jesus Christ. In him, we have access to the Father by entrusting ourselves to him in prayer. We attain our true goal in life. Jesus poured out on his people the spirit of adoption by making us children of God. United with Jesus, this new people of God constitutes the whole Christ. He offers them to his Father and gave him glory. This is the aim of his Father's plan for the salvation of all. Prayer to Jesus, true man. O Jesus, you are true man. You took upon yourself a human body and soul. You thought with a human mind, and you acted through a human will. But you are far above every other human. No one ever spoke like you, with such authority, freedom, and gentleness, indicating the path of love, justice, and sincerity. And no one ever matched your teachings. You spoke about the mystery of God in a way so elevated above others that you make it possible for us to come to know God and achieve a living love for him. Oh Jesus, no one ever acted like you either. You left us an example of the perfect human life by your preference for poverty, by your love for the poor and the sick, by your concern for the suffering, by your liberating message of salvation, by your espousal of peace and service, by your obedience to the Father, even to the death of the cross. O Jesus, help us to know you more. Help us to live with you so that we may live fully human lives. Satisfy us with yourself, the man for others, and with God. Perfect love, the man who is love, and God who is love. Prayer to Jesus through God. O Jesus, you are the Son of God. You resolve our problems and respond to our aspirations with unexpected fullness as the Son sent to us by the Father. You are the God who comes to meet us and manifest for us the good, the God whom we seek. You are the revelation of God for us, the full, perfect, and definitive revelation, God in person. In you, the God who is far off becomes the God who is near, the God with us and the God who is one of us, our companion of life's journey. You alone, O Lord, are the way, the truth, and the life, the Messiah and the Son of the living God. Petition to Jesus. O good Jesus, Word of the Eternal Father, convert me, Son of Mary, take me as her child. My Master, teach me. Prince of Peace, give me peace. My refuge, receive me. My Shepherd, feed my soul. Model of patience, comfort me. Make an humble of heart, help me to become like you. My Redeemer, save me. My God and my all, possess me. The true way direct me. Eternal truth, instruct me. Life of the saints, make me live in you. My support, strengthen me. My justice, justify me. My mediator with the Father, reconcile me. Physician of my soul, heal me. My judge, pardon me. My king, roll me. My sanctification, sanctify me. Abyss of goodness, pardon me. Living bread of heaven, feed me. Father of the prodigal, receive me. Joy of my soul, be my only happiness. My helper, assist me. Magnet of love, draw me. My protector, defend me. My hope, sustain me. Object of my love, unite me to yourself. Fountain of life, refresh me. My divine victim, atone for me. My last end, let me possess you. My glory, glorify me. Prayer to the miraculous infant of Brock. Dear Jesus, little infant of Brock, how tenderly you love us. Your greatest joy is to dwell among us and to bestow your blessing upon us. So many who turned to you with confidence have received graces and had their petitions granted. I also come before you now with this special request: a cure and containment of the COVID-19. Protect my family, my clans, my brothers, my sisters, my children, my grandchildren, my nieces and my nephew, my husband, my son-in-laws, my daughter-in-laws, and sister-in-laws, and brother-in-laws. My mother. Their infant, roll over me and do with me, and mine as you will. For I know that in your divine wisdom and love, you will arrange everything for the best. Do not withdraw your hand from me, but protect me and bless me forever. Dear infant, help me in my needs, make me truly happy with you in time and in eternity, and I shall thank you forever with all my heart. Prayer of praise to the holy name of Jesus. O glorious name of Jesus, gracious name, name of love and of power. Through you, sins are forgiven. Enemies are vanquished. The sick are freed from illness. The suffering are made strong and cheerful. You bring honor to those who believe, instructions to those who preach, strength to those who toil, and sustenance to those who are weary. Our love for you is ardent and glowing. Our prayers are heard. The souls of those who contemplate you are filled to overflowing. and all the blessed in heaven are filled with your glory. Grant that we too may reign with them through this your most holy name. Prayer to the crucified Christ. Lord Jesus, hanging on the cross, I raise sorrowful and shameful eyes to you. You have granted me untold blessings, and I have repaid you by contributing to your passion and death. My hands took part in your scourging. My voice was among those who denied you and called for your death. My thoughts brought about your crowning with thorns. My sins drove the nails into your hands and feet and the lance into your side. Dear Lord, forgive me for all these sins. You are great, glorious, and infinitely good. I am insignificant, selfish, and hopelessly sinful, but I am sorry for all my sins. And by the blood shed in your passion, I beg for forgiveness and for a share in your love and grace. Prayer to the seven last words. O divine Jesus, incarnate Son of God, for our salvation, you consented to be born in a stable to spend your whole life amid poverty, trials, and misery, and to die surrounded with sufferings on the cross at the hour of my death. Please say to your Father, Father, forgive her. Say to your beloved Mother, behold your daughter. Say to my soul, this day you shall be with me in paradise. My God, do not forsake me. In that hour I thirst. Yes, my soul thirsts for you who are the fountain of living waters. My life passes away like a shadow. In a short while, everything will be accomplished. Therefore, my adorable Savior, from this moment and for all eternity, into your hands I commend my spirit. Lord Jesus, receive my soul. Prayer in honor to the precious blood of Jesus. Precious blood of Jesus, infinite price of our redemption and both the drink and the lover of our souls. You continually plead the cause of all people before the throne of infinite mercy. From the depths of my heart, I adore you. Jesus, insofar as I am able, I want to make reparation for you. For the insults and outrages which you receive from human beings, especially from those who blaspheme you, who would not venerate this blood of infinite value, who does not feel inflamed with love for Jesus, who shed it, what would have become of me had I not been redeemed by this divine blood, who has drained it all from the veins of my Savior? Surely this was the work of love, O infinite love, which has given us this saving balm, O balm beyond all price. Welling up from the fountain of infinite love, grant that every heart and every tongue may render your praise and thanks now and forever. Amen. Holy name of Jesus, save us. My Lord, bless us and keep us. My Lord, show your face to us and have mercy on us. My Lord, turn your countenance to us and give us peace. My Lord, bless us. Amen. Lord, I offer you this blessed Trinity prayers for the cure of all the sickness and illnesses that bothers in the world, especially the virus, bacteria, COVID-19, MERS, SARS, anything that virus, Lord, cure and contain those virus and bacteria that bothers your creation. Protect and guide and lead us always against our battle to the coronavirus, to the MERS and SARS. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you like my video. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification button to keep you posted. Make sure to like and share my video. I love you guys. God bless you always. Thank you so much. God bless.